After several high-profile incidents involving disputes between lobstermen in Knox County, authorities say they will be more vigilant than ever, trying to prevent further problems along the coast. This comes after one man was shot and three boats had water intake lines cut, sinking two of them. Tonight, News 8's Keith Baldi takes a closer look at the rising tension and what lobstermen think lies ahead.
Authorities say they're working as hard as possible to catch the people responsible for the most recent incidents here, but people here think it's a different story. They don't expect anyone to be caught, and they say the tension will likely continue.
It's beautiful blue water on a sunny day, with fishing boats trolling what is invariably the Gold Coast of lobstering. State officials say more are caught in Knox County than anywhere else in the world. The latest figures from 2007 show that fishermen hauled in nearly 19 million pounds of lobster in Knox County, nine times York County's catch, and it was worth an estimated $83 million. But the competition for those dollars has consequences, and the Maine Marine Patrol says this year those with a cutthroat attitude are raising the tension to its boiling point.
I cannot remember in 32 years that fishing disputes, boundary, territorial disputes, and even personal family disputes have escalated to this level of violence.
This level of violence includes a shooting nearly 3 weeks ago on Matinicus Island and three boats getting sabotaged in Owl's Head Harbor Wednesday, causing two to sink. Add to that countless traps being cut or sunk and catches taken here in Knox County and throughout the state, and the result is serious concern among law enforcement agencies.
Well, historically, these type of actions have been going on for a long, long time. It's just recently it's really come to a head.
The response announced today, more patrols, interagency communication, personnel dedicated to investigating and heading off future problems, and an effort to convince community members to break the code of silence that the Marine Patrol says often characterizes the fishing industry. Efforts that met a certain level of skepticism this afternoon from those affected, including the son of one of the sabotage victims.
I think it's great that they're all together, but I still don't think it's going to help, really. It's not going to do any difference, and it could get worse, it could get better. You never know until it happens.
Authorities are trying to quell the tensions, but people here are realistic, knowing something could happen in the future. With that in mind, the owners of this wharf are today installing a video camera to be sure that if something happens in the future, they can catch it on tape. In Owl's Head, Keith Baldi, News 8.
And we have learned a fundraiser has been scheduled for the Owl's Head Lobstermen. Fittingly, it is a lobster dinner. It will be held Sunday, August 16th at 1 in the afternoon, and it is being held at the Ship to Shore Lobster Company located off of Main Street.